This is the first video in the range AMS 5.0 tech videos. It will exist next to the list of already available AMS 4.0 tech videos. In this video we will cover the installation of the AMS server. Also we will present you the new way of licensing and activation. When we open the installation folder, we discover two subfolders. Add-ons and a language folder. In this case EAN for English, under the add-ons folder we find the standard folder and there under the import-export tool and the AMC IP config tool. Although the access IP config tool is installed in companion with the server install. From here you can also install it separately on another PC. In the subfolder advanced you find the more specific tools that you can install next to AMS. Most of these folders also contain documents that explain the installation and use of these tools. In the language folder you find the main installation set. In the root we only find the executables for installing the server and the client. We will install the server first. We need to run it with administrative credentials. The installation starts with a welcome screen. Here you find a link to the YouTube channel with instruction videos in the AMS How To series. You can either scan the QR code with your cell phone. Or if you have a direct internet connection, click directly on the link. When you are logged on, you can subscribe for the playlist and then automatically it will be added to your libraries. Now continue the installation by clicking Next. You will see a list of all parts that will be installed now. You need them all. Read the end user license agreement and if you agree, click on Accept. Now it comes to the SQL Server configuration. You can decide to use it remotely. But if you install it locally, you will get the Microsoft SQL 2019 Express Edition. Accept the default installation folder. Or choose a different location for special circumstances. Now click install and the actual installation will start. That can take a minute or five to finish. It will create the icons on your desktop. And then start the actual installation of the SQL Server. When the green bar reaches the end, click Next and then Finish. The computer now needs to be restarted. After the computer is restarted, we can run the AMS config for the first time. We first want to run the licensing tool and therefore we need to start AMS with administrative credentials. There is no password assigned to the administrator yet and therefore we have to provide one. In the new password dialog, we can now immediately change the password and get advice about the strength or weakness of the chosen password. Set the password according to the password policy of your organization. When the password change is accepted, remember it well. From now on that will be the most important password. As long as AMS is still unlicensed, it lets you work with the built-in demo license. You can use it for 5 consecutive hours. From the main menu, we first select configuration and then licenses. With the built-in demo license, almost all features are available. And we can configure a large amount of devices. We want to replace the demo license with the one we bought. An AMS Lite license with extensions. So we start the license manager. That will bring us to a new dialog where we are instructed to save the system information file. That is the replacement of the computer signature that we used in the previous versions of AMS. It is now called the computer's fingerprint. That fingerprint is determined by, among other things, the computer host name and the disk ID. Save the file to your computer, where you can easily find it back. If your computer is not connected to the internet, copy the file to a connected PC and continue the licensing process there. By clicking continue, we are challenged to go to a new web portal. This URL replaces the old activation website that we used in the past. Here we need a new account. If you visit it for the first time, create one. After you created a new account, you will receive a confirmation email with a link to the logon page. Now you can log in with your new created account. On the software licensing page, we can start the actual three-step licensing process. In step 1, we need to supply a name and the software order ID that we received by email. The general manager of Roho Security enters his name and opens his email to find the so-called entitlement ID. From his mail, he copies the ID to the clipboard and pastes it in the empty field in the software order dialog. Now he claims his order. That consists of three parts: a base light license, a door expansion, and a client expansion. Click on the icon with the key. That will start the actual activation. Now it needs the system information file that we previously saved on an easy to remember location. We also need to enter an installation site. That can be anything. Then we click Next. And the system will start with the creation of our license. We confirm the product: AMS Lite. And we also confirm the two expansion licenses. By clicking the Activate button, the actual creation of the license file will happen. When all three components are activated, we get an overview of our licenses. And from here we can also download the activation file to our computer. The activation file needs to be downloaded and saved to the computer. When this is the connected PC and not the AMS PC, copy it over. Now that we are finished on the portal, we can close the web page and return to the AMS License Manager. That will ask us to import the just saved activation. When we click Finish, the license will be copied to the appropriate folder. And we can see the licensed products in the license overview. If you remove that file and restart the computer, your license is gone and you can import another license. Herewith we have finished this video about AMS 5.0 server installation and licensing. We have learned about what is modified in the installation steps and licensing procedure. If you want to learn how to upgrade your license from AMS 4.0, please find the tech video AMS 4.0 Part 10, Upgrading the License.